Good morning, Vipers. I'm Denton McGuire here with Max.
And I'm Nathan Marty here with Purpley. My niece named it.
That's possum.
You know what's actually really possum?
What?
Tech time with Eric.
Greetings and salutations, Verado. This is another episode of Tech Time with Eric. Today's special theme is pet-themed technology. So we're going to go over a couple things that have popped up on the internet from the past and up to now. The first one that I've seen recently that is kind of debatable that I've seen with Kickstarter is a cat translator, where it actually can analyze a cat's meow and basically tell you what your cat's thinking from when it wants to eat, if it's having fun, or to pretty much just leave it alone. You guys can check that out by simply Googling cat translator. There's multiple videos, so I can't tell if it's a gimmick or being true. The second thing I've seen going on over the internet that's both new and old is probably the automated dog feeder. You've probably seen an example of this on Honey, I Shrunk the Kids with Wayne Szalinski. He made one for his dog, and then there's also automated ones that you've seen in today where, you know, it distributes kibble or, you know, a treat or even launches the treat. So that's one example. You can actually Google that too. Multiple models are out there on the internet, depending on which one you want to get for your pooch. The third thing that's been floating around the internet that I've been informed about is a pet camera, to where you can actually monitor your pet. The pet can see you. You can see the pet. So you can kind of, you know, bridge that gap when you're at work or you're traveling, so your dog knows that you are in the house in spirit. So that's one cool little device. I don't know whether or not it runs off Wi-Fi or data, but I'm assuming due to its flexibility that anything is possible. And then the fourth one, I think this is one a bit of a joke, but it looks pretty serious, is probably the dog collar camera, to where you can actually see where your dog's walking, see where they are. I think that's more of a gimmick in conjunction with the dog tracker that you can implant into your dog. But I have to say the pet technology has grown quite a bit since the early 2000s, and I see it expanding further on as we develop our technology. So that's the end of today's episode. This is Tech Time with Eric, and you stay classy, Verado.
What's up, Vipers? This is Andres and Zunzo with KVHS, and I'm going to be asking students what kind of pets they've lost.
Pet I lost was a chinchilla maybe 4 years ago. I was moving from Ohio to New Mexico, and my car didn't have air conditioning, and they can't sweat, so it got too hot and stressed and ended up dying like maybe 30 miles from my house. So I was pretty sad about that.
I lost my dog like 2 years ago. It was really sad, and yeah, it was, she died because of kidney failure.
This one time I lost my pet. It was my dog and he just ran away, and I came home and he was just gone. Ran around the neighborhood, but then I found him.
When I was little, like 7 or 8, I had 2 little frogs, and you know, I didn't know how to take care of them. So, you know, they kind of got malnourished and died.
So I lost an animal when I was in high school. I was showing in FFA and my cow kind of busted down the fence and ran away and ran a half mile away, and the news station locally found my cattle running through the streets.
This has been Andres and Zunza with KVHS signing off. Have a great day, Vipers.
I was privileged to host a total of 6 foreign exchange students this year, each coming from a different country and boasting a unique personality. Teachers and peers alike are responsible for showing these students what it means to be one Verado. This week, we were honored to sit and talk with Anthony from Brazil, who shared the advantages along with the challenges of venturing to a new country for an entire year.
My name is Anthony Espinoza Paiotti, and I'm from Brazil. So, a few years ago, my father was telling me about when he came to the U.S. to get this experience, and I thought that would be fun to do it, and I wanted that to me too. I've been to the U.S. for vacation, and I've been to Orlando and Miami and those big cities, like those vacation cities.
Anthony has adjusted very well to Verado, making many friends and managing to make it onto the soccer team. But with these successes, there have been some struggles.
The biggest difference between my school and Verado is probably that I have to go to the classes instead of the teachers coming to my class. Because like in Brazil, the teachers come to your class, and here you have to go to the teacher's class, and that's probably the biggest difference. The biggest challenge I've had so far was to make friends, because like in Brazil, people are way more sociable, and I was kind of used to that. So, like, when I came here, I thought, like, everyone will talk to me. But, like, it was not like that.
A big thank you to Anthony for taking the time to sit and talk with us. Now, here he is in Portuguese to sign us off.
I'm Anthony Espinosa Paiori, Um Mundo, Um Verrado.
We really miss hosting for you guys, so we came back for this episode. And speaking of us, Beauty and the Beast tryouts are on the 30th and 31st. To sign up, talk to Mr. Spence.
Congratulations to VHS Palm for winning third in the competitions.
And congratulations to Cheer for winning first in state.
Woo! Well, you know, since it's the pet episode, I was thinking, Max is always doing really annoying things, like, around the house all the time that they really get on my nerves.
Oh my gosh, Purpley? Oh, it makes me so mad. All he does is swim around and around and around and around. And around and around.
Oh my god.
That's all he does.
Wow. Well, there's a segment coming up next that really relates with our pet peeves.
Where's my Stitch? Callie, would you... Callie! What the heck?
So I have this golden doodle named Callie, and she can get on my nerves sometimes.
Hi, Callie. Get down!
And she likes to jump on me whenever I go through the front door and is super annoying. Like, she knocks me over and I don't think she realizes that she could have the potential to kill me. This dog.
Go away. Nobody wants your stink breath while they're eating.
And whenever I eat, she always just gives me this stare, like, I'm waiting. But on the bright side, no matter how annoying she can get at times, I still love her.
Morning, Vipers. I'm Quinn Russell, along with
Noah Powers.
Here for your weekly sports update, VSPN. Wrestling has their senior night today at 4 p.m. against Dysart and Buckeye Union.
Girls basketball has their next home game Friday night at 7 p.m. against Lake Havasu.
Girls soccer has their next away game tomorrow at 6 p.m. against Lake Havasu.
Boys basketball has their next away game Friday night against Lake Havasu at 7 p.m.
Boys soccer, congrats on a great season and your 9-game winning streak.
This has been Noah Powers
and Quinn Russell
with your weekly sports update, VSPN.
Good morning, Vipers. I'm Danny, here with your weekly Viper Weather Watch. Today is going to be a sunny day with a high of 73 and a low of 44. Winds for the day heading east-northeast at 14 miles per hour. There's 0% chance for precipitation, and humidity is at 20%. Heading over to our 7-day forecast, tomorrow, temperatures expected to be in the mid-70s. Then, heading into the weekend, Friday, expected to be in the high 60s, Saturday, in the low 70s, and Sunday, in the high 70s. Back into school week, Monday and Tuesday, also in the high 70s. This has been your weekly Viper Weather Watch.
Hey Vipers, Natalia Ramirez here with KVHS. Today I'm going to be asking people about what their favorite animal is and why.
If I could have any pet in the world, it'd be a grizzly bear because I want to ride to school on it.
If I could have an animal, I would have a pig, like a little teacup pig, because they're so adorable and they're like little dogs. I have a little dog that looks like a pig and it's so cute.
If I could have any animal for a pet, it'd be a shark because they're really cool.
If I could have any animal for a pet, it'd be a lemur because I think they're a lot of fun.
If I could have any animal as a pet, it would be a unicorn so I could have free travel to places.
If I could choose one exotic animal, I would choose a wallaroo. It's a small kangaroo, and it's nocturnal, and I stay up late, so we'd get along.
Everyone has had a wide variety of what they would want, but I would want a Shamu orca whale because they're really cute, and I'd want him in my house to like swim around, and I could see him. So yeah, that's all I have for today, Vipers. Bye.
Wrestling will be hosting senior night tonight, so please come out and support.
Girls basketball will be having a home game on Friday, so come out and watch the game.
What's your favorite pet?
That's a really rough decision to make.
Well, don't tear yourself up about it.
Yeah, just watch this video, and I'm pretty sure there will be a positive outcome.
Mex doesn't like your puns.
He loves them.
My name is Steven, and since this week's theme of the weekly show is pets, we're going to go around asking people what their favorite animal is.
My favorite animal is a lion.
It's a lion.
A liger.
I like chihuahuas. It is.
My favorite animal is a fish.
My name is Cooper Coleman, and my favorite animal is a dog.
My favorite animal is a dog.
My favorite animal is Stephen Applegate.
My favorite animal is a sea turtle.
My favorite animal is a zebra.
My favorite animal is a sea slug.
Hi, I'm Nathan. Denton is my dog. I picked him up about 3 years ago. He was lost in a ditch. We never exactly found out what kind of breed Denton is. He's a very rare breed. We think that he's a mix of all of the ugly dogs or something.
I've been Nathan's dog for about 3 years now. It's pretty great. I like it a lot. We don't know where it came from. I don't know my mom and dad. Some of my favorite interests and hobbies are tennis, frisbee. I like chasing golf balls. I also like barking at strangers and random moving objects. I also like chasing cats, poodles.
My wife and I have been trying for a while to have him become a service dog. And he just has anxiety sometimes. And he barks at people every once in a while. You know, he's a little awkward too sometimes.
Sorry, he's just such a good dog.
Well, Vipers, we really hope you enjoyed that perfect episode.
Well, we've been your hosts, Denton McGuire and Max.
And Purpley and Nathan Marty. Have a good day, guys.
Have a good day, Vipers.
We wuff you.